Back takes the phone. I want everyone to make sure that everyone is connected to Dr. Back. And I'm going to tell you why. This man is a force of nature. He is an unbelievable entrepreneur, a dentist by circumstance, as he says. And I want you guys to make sure that you're following him. So everybody pick up your phones and open up your LinkedIn app. Sorry for hijacking the microphone. Everybody pick up your phone. Take it out. Open your LinkedIn app. Now in your LinkedIn app, there's a wonderful feature that's actually a real game changer that no one ever uses. So I really try to take advantage of it whenever I'm in a crowd. Go to your, there's a little button with two heads on the bottom next to the messaging app. See that little button? It's like it's the network, it's the connection button. You guys see that on the bottom? Now on top of that, next to the number of connections you have, it says find nearby. Yeah. Find nearby. Dr. Back, is yours open? Because I'm doing this for you. He just has a Heineken in his hand. On the count of three, we're all going to press the find nearby, and all of us will be instantaneously connected. Are you ready? Jenny, you ready? I know you're more of an Instagram gal. Here we go. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3, find nearby. Go for it. It's going to auto-populate. It's doing some Wi-Fi love right now. We're making Wi-Fi babies. Right this second, we're connecting. Now, everyone who's activated this app at the same time is gonna show up on your nearby. Dr. Back will be on this list. We will all be connected, and we will all continue our relationship. Without further ado, Dr. Back Nguyen, ladies and gentlemen. Hey.
Back. Six, mais qui est plus qu'un docteur, qui est rendu un co-auteur. Parce que j'en ai écrit un livre ensemble. Bak va être en train de faire un record du monde, avoir écrit le plus grand nombre de livres en une année. C'est un homme inspirant. C'est un homme que la stratégie, il en mange à tous les jours. C'est un homme qui est remarquable. Je tiens à vous applaudir, puis je tiens à introduire Dr. Bak, un ami, un bâtisseur, puis une inspiration. Ouais!
So I'm a dentist. Every time I say that, I lost half my friends. So we're pretty good making new friends. And thank you, Jamie. Thank you, Jan, for the intro. Thank you, Hugo and Antoine, to invite me here. I've been told that I have to prepare 12 to 15 minutes of speech. And after hearing Jamie, my speech is gone. Honestly, it's gone. But mainly, you heard the intro. I'm a dentist. I was one of you guys. I'm still one of you. But I decided one day to wake up and say, let's do something with what I received from God. So from that day, I decided to take my own hands and make something with it. And then I realized that I was working with the less valuable piece of my body, my hands. When you look at me, you see exactly what you want to see. I'm Asian, I should be a nerd, and I'm a doctor just because my parents say so. Honestly, I hated it. I survived school, and then I tried to fit in to the mold for 20 years. And then I said that was enough. So what happened is I woke up, that would take a lot of effort and pain, and I suddenly started to accept who I was deep inside. To accept my strength, accept my weakness, and to say that it's okay not to fit in everywhere. And the problem is I didn't fit anywhere anymore. So last year it all started when a friend of mine told me that you have a nice vibe. You can inspire people. Let's put you on stage and let's have people listen to you. I said, okay. And I'm a pride guy, so if I say okay, I'll do it. Took him 4 weeks before he told me, yeah, you know, by the way, you'll be speaking after Michelle Obama.
Really?
It was too late for me. I couldn't back art out of this one, so I had to do it. But that scared the crap out of me. So he was looking at me and said, okay, I know that you need it, but if you need some preparation, just look at some TED Talks and prepare one or two. I'll tell you which one is the best one. For the first time of my life, I took something seriously. And within 2 weeks, I prepared 21 TED Talks, plus an intro and a conclusion, and I had a book. My first book went in two weeks. Then I went back to him and said, Russell, which one do you like, bro? I was looking at me and saying, holy cow, you did it. But now I have a news for you. Michelle Obama will not be coming to Toronto in November, but she had up for Paris by February. So you have more time and you can speak in French now. So, honestly? And then something happened. It's like I spent my life saying that gratitude is a good thing, that gratitude is the only path for the future. And now I'm one of those people now that are successful, and again, I'm gonna just turn my back to French people. That was unacceptable. So I knew that I was fucked. I wanted the story that I'd be finishing that book in a month. So I beat myself up to the blood, to the bone, and 2 weeks and 6 hours later, I was rewriting the whole book in French. 25,000 words became 25,000 words. Now I can tell you that I know exactly the difference between English and French. And people were asking me, so how do you do it? It was about an hour, except for the French version, but I woke up an hour earlier in the day, started writing, and by 7, I was good for my day. So everything was adding on top of my regular schedule of being a CEO and a dentist. So after I finished the French version, my job was done, just to learn that Michel Blanc won't be making it for Paris. But I had the habit now to write in the morning. So for 3 weeks, I was in welfare, let's say, and I was bored. So I started another book, and another, and another. Now I'm finishing this month with 12 months, and I'll be finishing not 7, but 9 books. Thank you. We own Amazon, by the way. One of the last ones that we wrote, starting this month though, it's called Momentum Transfer. And Coach Ya, Coach Yino, Coach, they're here, has squeezed me out of my juice, let's say. Man, people hear you talk, people want, they come to hear what you can, how you can inspire them. But you just say vague ideas. You're in the cloud. Give us something true. So those two sit me down and they squeeze the juice out of me. Say, we want to know your secret. So Dino and I went back 5 years ago and we have kind of developed Awakers. Mainly, I'm successful when I need to be successful, but the rest, I'm the laziest guy possible.
That's true.
And then my wife looked at me and said, you need to lose some weight. Then I met with Dino. I said, okay, my wife and my coach sent me here, and can you do something about this? So you can, I did pay him for 5 years though. And I was looking at him and said, sure. And then he took the time to introduce me to physical activity. I know that you won't believe me, but when I graduated from school, I had 6-pack. Today I have 1 big pack. I have pictures to prove that, but what happened is I didn't care anymore because my focus was now on success. My focus was on my career, but so you know, your body's working as a whole. So Dino has the genius idea to say, hey, this guy likes to talk. Let's play some judo with him. So I booked with him and I didn't pay my training. And no, the guy is pretty smart. He make you pay for a year in advance or something like that. So yeah, you have to show up. So I was showing up. And then, see, the bag is mine, and I'm pretty sure that his story is different. So let's try to make the most of this guy. Let's try to make him come back and have him pay me instead. So he made me talk. He was asking this question about business. And I was a little out there, so I was answering his questions about business. Question after question, the whole session was done. hey, I talk about it for 3 times in that program. But from the basics, by September, we'll be launching that book. Hopefully that this book can be find any value to you. Because if I summarize this, yes, I know that I can do a lot. Yes, I know that I can be a tornado. But when you look at the eye of each tornado, it is peaceful. The eye need to be organized, need to have some peace in it. And the peace is you. So you heard a lot of speakers today talking about your why. The why can be an eye. But mainly what I've learned, if you want that eye to last, if you want that why to be powerful, that eye is you. It's the confidence you have in yourself, making sure that you can do something. And the momentum, what is the momentum? It's just action gaining speed. So the idea is, and the message I'm bearing today, it's every one of you can make the difference. That every one of you can have the power, because I didn't have any power before. And tonight, suddenly tonight, you're here listening to me. And Coach Jan and Coach Dino will make sure that that power will be available to each one of you. So momentum transfer is the next step. And before they cut me, I don't know why you said that to me, because the other guy talks for so long. But if you allow me one advice, we are all looking for a worth in life. And what I learned is worth is not based on pride. Your eye might be based on pride. But what's worth is, it's the usefulness you have to others. This is how you're finding your worth. So with this, hopefully you'll be finding your own power, drawing your own vision, and find your worth in life. Thank you.